And here we are on said map. It is our red Terran player down at the bottom of the map from the team Dignitas. It is Select. Ever wonder why he capitalizes the last two letters in the name? I have no idea.
No,
I'll have to ask him sometime. And up at the top of the map in the pink from the team Prime, it is their champion for this tournament of champions. It is Creator.
Yes, and here we go. ESV Cloud Kingdom is the map. This has been a map that's actually produced some kind of cool games. Actually, one really ridiculous game. If you guys remember Game 4 between OGS Supernova and Zenex Life, that one ended up being quite a bit crazy. But we'll certainly see what it produces here. I've not seen many PVTs on this map, to be honest.
I actually realized I just was able to read what they said to each other and understand it.
Ooh.
That was amazing. I'm learning Korean.
Congratulations.
I'm understanding more things. I feel like Antonio Banderas in what Eaters, if the, it was a movie version of Eaters of the Dead, the seventh warrior, something like that. You know what I'm talking about, right?
No,
oh, man.
I'm sorry.
Somebody out there knows, but he's like sitting around the campfire and he starts to understand what the Vikings are saying.
Yeah.
We'll have
oh,
to
wow.
watch it sometime. It's
That's
a great
impressive.
Movie. It's awesome, awesome movie. Good book too, but.
Antonio Banderas, fine actor there, but. Let's see.
That's
here.
Right.
As Select looks like he's bypassing Gasser now, building up well over 100 resources and putting down his 14th SCV before anything else goes up. Creator, of course, gas on normal time, so we'll see what he moves into here in just a bit. More importantly, of course, when he gets his second gas and how many gateways he puts down at the beginning of the game.
Yeah. So we're probably going to see a pretty, not normal build from Select. There's that second barracks going down on the low ground, so it's not going to be a one barracks fast expand like we thought it was going to be.
No.
Interesting. And this is kind of what we were saying about Select before the game started. You know, he really likes to be aggressive in this matchup a lot of times. Not every time, but a lot of times it's how he chooses to play it. And I would say against a player like Creator Prime, that is the perfect strategy to choose because you know that if you let Creator get into the late game, it is going to be very difficult to stop him. Select, in fact, I think is actually one of the few players that would have a better chance in the late game just because he's so good at using ghosts. But beyond that, I think it's definitely in Select's best interest to try to end the game early in this series.
All right. Well, we'll see what he can offer here in just a bit as Creator. Cybernetics Core just about to finish up. He would have thrown down second gas by now if he was doing a conventional like 3-gate sentry expand or something like that, or even a 1-gate sentry expand. So he's going to bypass that for now. Actually, decides to put up his Stalker right away, chrono-boosting that out, in fact, so he can take out the SEV. Select, on the other hand, producing his Marines two at a time. He's not added on gas yet, just saving up his minerals for a little while.
Yeah, Creator Prime playing that pretty typical TVP style. He likes to chrono boost out that Stalker just so he can get out there on the map and get a little bit of control and things like that. So it's going to pop out in just a second. And it looks like we're going to see a one-gate expand out of him as well. Mm-hmm. So he'll be able to go and potentially punish Select if Select doesn't have a bunker. Although with two barracks pumping out Marines, he should have enough to actually just push the Stalker back. You know, sometimes you see the Stalkers come in when someone's doing a one-rax expand, and they can get a little bit of damage done if the bunker isn't there to protect the Marines. But in this case, Select should be just fine. He has selected the correct opening against this, dare I say.
Oh, God. Oh, wait. Creator Prime's four-gating, by the way.
Oh, he is. And he's going to lose his Stalker here, too, if he's not careful. And his Zealot Select with some great micro there, taking down a unit and a half of Creator Prime. And, yes, a four-gate from Creator. I love this about this kid. He's starting to kind of throw some wacky stuff in there. But will it work? I don't know, man. I mean, Select's got a pretty safe build against this right now.
Well, Creator is doing, he's continuing to produce probes throughout the whole process. He didn't stop on 19, so it's not that super hard, really quick four gates. He does have a probe sneaking around his opponent's base, though. Makes his way up, does kill the Zealot, starting to go after the Stalker. It's very low in health, has to back up to the top of the ramp. There's already another Stalker waiting for that as well. Select has pulled a couple of SCVs along with this push.
Yeah, he wants to build a bunker or two if he can, or at least buffer a bit of damage here, but he is not going to do too much at all. In fact, he might be opening himself up for a counterattack here because these four gateways have just finished, and here comes the warp in now for Creator Prime. Select realizing that he's going to be potentially in a bit of trouble here.
We'll certainly find out. He loses another Stalker. He's pulling a couple of probes off of the line. These bunkers do not look like they're going to get up at the same time. Three Stalkers are starting to swing around the bottom, but Select is prepared by putting up a bunker himself.
He does, but there's only one Marine inside, so will it be enough to defend? Creator Prime defends at home fairly easily, and yeah, it looks like he's not paying attention to just exactly how many Marines he's being hit by. Okay, there we go.
Yeah,
now he knows. All right, so Select does have the bunker filled.
Yep.
Another Marine does die, but it looks like Creator Prime might be able to deny that natural expansion for a while, which is good because he needs to get an expansion going himself pretty quick.
Oh, yes.
Here.
Very much so. And the benefit he has for his economy is that he has been producing workers the entire time. Nice job shutting down the barracks off to the left as well. Going to get repaired up here pretty quickly. And we'll see what his next move is. Is he going to pull back those stalkers for a while? He's keeping a couple out on the map to contain and... started to walk those back, but deciding not to as he will put up another Nexus.
Yeah, what a bizarre opening from Creator Prime going for that economical four gate. I think he just wanted to be very safe against anything Select may decide to do in the early game.
Mm-hmm.
And he certainly was. You know, he correctly called that Select would be getting aggressive early on, and he shut it down pretty rapidly. Supplies about even. I'd like to see what the worker count is right now, if possible, as we see that Robo Bay go down. About even for both players, one more probe for Creator Prime than Select has SCVs. But other than that, fairly even. Select, I would say, in fact, a little bit ahead due to mules, of course.
And he is double producing those. And oh, Creator was a little slow in reacting there. Loses one Stalker, takes a little bit of extra damage as well.
Yep.
Now walking up with that Zealot in addition. Looks like a Bunker trying to get put up at the front for Select, but just one lone SCV going out to
He's
put
so
that
brave.
Down.
He's the Marauder on the high ground. Okay, never mind. He's not so brave after all.
He does have a special protector sitting up there.
Yep, he's okay. Yeah. He's got his Guardian Angel Marauder. Although, you know, you'd need some pretty heavy-duty wings on those guys. They look
pretty
heavy.
Kidding.
Yeah.
That's pretty hefty. That's what, like 10 feet tall, 12 feet tall, something like that?
That's the thing. You know, like, do they put... It's probably just like a regular-sized person in that, too, you know? So, I mean, that's like... He's more machine now than man.
But can rebuild him.
It's not a machine. He's going to be heavy either way. They shouldn't stand on the edge of that cliff. You know, cliff edges are prone to collapsing.
I guess that's
true. Dangerous move there by Select, putting those Marauders right on the edge of that cliff.
They are intentionally leaving themselves hanging there. That's unfortunate.
That's
they have so much to live for.
That's right. Sometimes they just, you know, they like to be left hanging a little bit, but not too much.
That's true.
In general, they don't like to be left hanging. That's just how Marauders are.
Only leave me a modicum of hanging.
That's right.
I think that's
only
their new
like
tagline.
To hang a bit.
Yes. Sounds like a Marauder to me.
I think so. Yeah. Oh, I like this by Select. You see more and more Western Terran players doing this, putting that supply depot wall up in front of the bunker. It's not quite as popular in Korea, but, you know, and Select is Korean, but I would call him a Western player since he has kind of spent most of his time on Western teams, you know, playing on the NA server. So, that is a characteristic of Western Terrans to put that supply depot wall in front of the bunkers like that. But it will keep you fairly safe against some of those later gateway timings. Creator Prime, though, he does see everything.
Nice, just buffering that first bit of Zealot damage as well. Yep, Creator gets in, sees pretty much everything, knows the medevacs are just popping out as well. He has decided to take a third base, though. That Nexus is about halfway done. He is producing off of his Robo. He is moving up to Twilight Council, but no forges down, just working off those four gates. And, oh, the SCV jumps right in and sees the Nexus.
Yeah, great scouting by Select to check that third base location just to see what's going on. And, yeah, that is a signal to move out if ever I did see one. The two medevacs popping out right in time with this as well, giving Select a nice little opportunity to come in and pressure this third base. If we look at the army that Creator has there, as we see Select throw down that command center, it just does not look like it's going to be enough to stop that. It depends. You know, his sentries do have a lot of energy. Well, they actually don't have a lot of energy, so that warping might be just what he needs, but either way, it's a fairly even fight damage-wise.
All right, well, we'll see if Select decides to move up into the main here, forces Creator to split his own units just a little bit, or if he'll produce another observer just to get better vision over his opponent.
This is kind of what the position that Select likes to put people in. He likes to kind of get their armies moving around, and that gives him opportunities to jump in a medevac or two and drop somewhere where they're not expecting it. So wouldn't be surprised at all to see Select try to jump into the main here. But right now, you know, like you mentioned, just kind of doing a little bit of positioning. Creator Prime sending out that probe to do a little bit of scouting here, but I don't think he saw the army sneaking off to the left there. I think Select may be able to get a little bit of a jump on the main base if he decides to drop there.
Yeah, well, we'll see. As Creator shifting over a lot of Stalkers, if he decides to just do a big push through the front, though, that's going to be terrible for Creator. He's got to warp in a couple of units and may have to give up this base. Trying to get back with those Stalkers as quick as possible. It looks like Select is a little more interested in going after the army rather than going after the Nexus for now. He will certainly be able to engage that, but it gives time for the Stalkers to come back. Guardian Shield is down right away. Nice job to target fire the Sentry out of the middle, and the Stalkers are finally starting to do a little bit of damage, but the Immortal is going to fall, and it's relatively fragile. Stalkers are all that's left.
Yeah, so Select doing some damage, but was it worth it? He's going to lose this medevac as well. He killed two Marauders, but, you know, not a lot else. He did trade a bit, but I don't know if this attack was worth it for Select. I think the fact that he's macroing so hard behind this, that he's producing so many units, makes it okay, but something about that attack felt a little bit uncomfortable to me. You know, he didn't kill any probes, didn't really damage the Nexus. Basically, those two Immortals are kind of all he got out of that, but,
yeah.
You know, we'll see if the macro can kind of help him keep up anyway.
All right, well, we'll see if that could be the case. He is working off of his third orbital command as well. Both these guys have very, very good, well-developed economies now. Basically, both equivalent. Select a little bit ahead in mineral gathering, of course, with the three mules, but Creator is going to be pulling in a lot of gas here soon with his fifth and sixth assimilators, now starting to produce those colossi as well.
A three-base Protoss is a pretty terrifying thing, and he does have Thermal Lance on the way now as well, and he's going to have a lot of colossi. When this does pop out, you know, we might see some sort of timing that he chooses to do around maybe three colossi or so and 1-1. You know, he actually did have 1-1 going, but he canceled it and just restarted that now. Interesting. So I wonder if he was just trying to squeeze out just a few more gateways there. I didn't really see anything else building.
Mm-hmm.
Colossus is already on the way, but either way, a little bit of a delay in the upgrades. In fact, Select will have 1-1 a little bit sooner than Creator Prime in this.
All right, well, we'll see here now as Creator Prime, of course, will be able to move into 2-2 very, very quickly on. Has Select put up his second engineering bay? He has, and he has an armory, and there we go. There's plus two weapons just starting as soon as I say that.
Yep.
Three ghosts heading out, though. I don't think he researched Mobius. Oh, he did research Mobius Reactor. I apologize. I just missed that before. So these ghosts will have an EMP ready to go as soon as they pop out of that barracks.
It's usually pretty common for Terran players to do the same thing with Mobius Reactor and ghosts as we see Zerg players do.
Yep.
With
pathogen
glands. That's the upgrade, pathogen glands and infestors. You know, you get the upgrade finishing right as the first couple units of that type come out, just so you have that extra energy right away on your first units.
Now, Select, I actually want to take his vision here. He's not seen the robotics bay. I would hope he would assume the colossi were going to hit at some point, but he hasn't produced any Vikings or anything.
Yeah, I don't know if he's expecting this. He scans it. Well, now he knows.
Right.
He may be expecting colossi at this point.
No, I don't know.
You know, he's still making medevacs. He is one of those types of players, too, that tends to skip a little bit on Vikings and rely mostly on ghosts and positioning. And just kind of keeping his units healed through a lot more medevacs. So we'll have to see how he handles this. He hasn't canceled his two medevacs that he has building now. He is putting down another starport. So, I think we are going to see him put in a few Vikings at least to try to catch up to a decent count to stay safe. But now we have Creator slipping over to Templar as well. So we've got a bit of a tech switch from our Protoss player as well.
Fourth base coming up for Select as
Fourth
and
fifth.
Fifth actually already finished over on the right-hand side of the map.
Yep.
So he is starting to add in Vikings now, plus two weapons well on the way. 2-2 is pretty far along, though, for Creator. And 2-2 plus the rest of this army, plus a couple of Archons in there. That's going to be a pretty devastating force. We'll see if Select is going to be prepared now, adding in those Vikings.
You know, it's interesting when you watch Terran versus Protoss. It's actually similar in some ways to a TVT when you have Bio against Mech. The Bio player just can't really engage directly in a lot of cases, but you try to take a lot of bases and engage on multiple fronts and try to surround your opponent with your army. Just kind of come at them from the side rather than dead on. And I think Select has a really good grasp of how to utilize that same type of philosophy in TVP. That's what we're seeing right now. We're seeing him take a lot of bases, getting those upgrades going, and you can see he keeps moving around his army. You know, he keeps making Creator Prime reposition himself. He's trying to find that good angle. And if he keeps doing this, there's a very good chance that he will find that good angle. But, you know, a direct confrontation with that army, I don't think is going to be very pretty for our Terran player.
And Select is finishing up a ton of, actually hits all of the Stalkers, but really not much else. None of the charge lots or anything along those lines. He's trying to run directly into the natural. We'll see how much damage he can do. He is going
quite
to lose this army, but is it going to be worth it taking out the Nexuses in production? He's already done quite a bit of damage as is. His opponent can warp in nothing at the moment. He's starting to tear through these pylons.
Mm-hmm. And let's see how Select plays this, because he could just kill off those forges. In fact, that's what he did. And looks like he's just deciding to fight it. Good angle for Select here.
Great job by Creator, though, to make sure he took out those medevacs so there was no chance of retreat. He is going to take out this army completely.
Yeah, you know, that's the thing. I was like, well, if Select can get in there and kill some important buildings and then fly out in medevacs, that could be pretty good. But as it is, you know, like you said, Creator focused down the medevacs as a priority. And because of that, Select lost his entire army, and that is going to leave him very, very, very vulnerable. in the next couple minutes, he is going to lose at least one base here, if not the game, from this counterattack from Creator Prime.
And there are still so many Colossi out. Yes, there's a lot of Vikings, nine of them, but once Select goes through those, he only has a smattering of units on the ground. Creator in such a strong position right now. We'll see if he can push through and try and just end up taking the game. Planetary Fortress morphing in over on the right-hand side.
Yeah, and that finish literally just in time. Now Creator Prime is going to have to engage us a little bit carefully. He might just be able to focus it down fast enough that it doesn't matter. In fact, yeah, that's what he will do. So I guess the Planetary Fortress didn't matter all that much after all. Quick, build a refinery! I want
what else
to go
is an SCV
going to
do?
That's right. He wanted to be useful to the very end. Another base going down for Select here, forced to float away. And yeah, just the fact that he lost all those medevacs and couldn't retreat in that run-by made a huge, huge difference in this game right now. You know, I liked it right up until the point where he lost the medevacs.
Yeah.
And I think this one is going to be pretty much over for Creator Prime. Select, I don't believe, can win this fight.
I don't think so either. I mean, it's he can't even dispatch of all the Colossi, and he had a ton of Vikings sitting overhead. Certainly has no chance to take out things on the ground. Looks like Creator is going to roll to victory here in game number one. These ghosts are being oh so annoying, sitting there still cloaked, but that's not going to be enough.
It's a bit odd that he doesn't have an observer with this. He's making another one now.
Gotten it killed, yeah.
Yeah, may have died here, but it looks like he's going to be able to do plenty of damage anyway. You know, those ghosts don't kill things terribly fast. There we go. Observer on the spot now. The ghosts will die, and the Archons versus SCVs is a pretty good fight for the Archons, so...
Yes, it is.
Yeah, I think we're probably going to see a GG fairly soon here. Select just trying to hold on for dear life, but... 38 supply to 85, not looking too good for our Terran player here.
No, Select a player, though, that does like to play to the bitter end.
He does.
Somehow, through good control and things like that, take games off of players even when it looks like all hope is lost. This is a situation, though, I don't think he's going to be able to do it.
Yeah, that base is just not saturated enough to give him the income that he needs, and it looks like those charge lots are going to come in as well. And, yeah, not attack. It's a little bit dangerous here, but... Select is a very scrappy kind of player. You know, he wants to play, like you said, to the bitter end, but, you know, in this case, I think the lead is a little bit too big for Creator Prime. Wasn't quite able to finish off Select there, so Select will, be able to kind of stay in it for a little while longer, I guess. I mean, if he gets some miracle drops, maybe he can pull something out here, but it's going to be tough.
52 workers to just 13 at the moment, and Creator just waiting for the moment to push in and destroy his opponent now. Let's see, he's warping in some more High Templar. He's got a couple more Archons. They are sitting on 2-2 upgrades, not vesting in 3-3 quite yet. Select trying to move up pretty aggressively, stems all of his forces. The Archon's going to roll through here in just a second. Picks up a couple of those hurt units just to get him away.
Yeah, those are all of his forces too as well. Well, let's see. So Creator Prime... He does still have three mining bases going. Obviously, his main is mined out.
Yes.
Say that like five times fast. His main is mined out.
Wow.
That's actually, well, maybe it's not that hard. Well, you know, if you said it a lot of times really fast, maybe it would be.
Yeah, say anything a lot of times fast and it gets pretty difficult, though.
His mighty main is miserably mined out.
Oh, boy, the alliteration.
GG.
GG.